Okay, so Mastercard is starting to use blockchain. Now, obviously they're not using their own digital asset, but what they're using is the underlying technology to Bitcoin. The Royal Bank of Canada is actually doing this same thing. They're using the blockchain to the advantage because it makes things quicker and cheaper for them. These are key points. They're key points for any company functioning. It actually may be one of the inducing factors that bring blockchain to the mainstream. Now, will MasterCard be able to keep up with the transactional costs that Litecoin has cross borders? Or what about Bitcoin? Seems unlikely to me. But this is my little drop-in conversation about MasterCard and blockchain. Obviously, MasterCard doesn't want to say that it's a blockchain-based cryptocurrency because that would get them into a whole new set of regulatory troubles. They themselves are connected to over 22,000 banks. Their cross-border payment systems are reduced drastically in the cost and the time that it takes to do these by using blockchain. Royal Bank of Canada, again, is also doing that same thing. I think we're going to see consistently more and more industries go the way of the blockchain. Now, all that means is that the mainstream adoption rate for things like blockchain, other technical aspects and uses of them, such as Ethereum or Bitcoin, Litecoin, there are countless numbers of these. It's really going to come to the definitions and linguistics that we start to use. They're no longer going to be cryptocurrencies. These are crypto-based ideas or crypto-centralized ideas. But what about property? This is cryptographic real estate. What about Ethereum? These are cryptographic smart contracts. It is time that we start changing the linguistics. It's important to do that because as we move forward into these worlds, it's going to be important to notice the difference between them. For instance, again, MasterCard using the blockchain or IBM using the blockchain. These are somewhat centralized systems using a decentralized form of accounting. Again, very, very different from what Bitcoin is in its nature. It's fundamentally disruptive to those systems and they're trying to keep up. So, MasterCard's gonna use blockchain too.